to NC Drama Club's performance of The Help Desk. It has been a very strange year, and we are really thankful to be able to have been able to come in here into the theater and play and have fun and just be silly after some stresses that we've all lived through. And we're also very thankful that we are able to have a live audience. It's not a full house, but it's a lot larger than I was ever hoping and dreaming for. Thank you for coming out and supporting Life Theater. Thank you for supporting our young actors. They are amazing, wonderful, beautiful people, and I hope you enjoy the show.
Is anyone gonna get that? All right, guess I got it then. I guess I'll take this one. Whatever. It's cool. Y'all are disappointing. Help desk, this is Jerry. How can I help you?
Hey there, I'm trying to log into the network, and I can't seem to make it work.
Oh, okay. Boy, that's a challenge. Glad I picked up this call.
Sorry?
No, no. Go ahead. Walk me through how terribly difficult this must be.
So, I put in my ID and password.
Uh-huh.
And then it says it can't log me in.
Right. Mystery. What could it possibly be?
Well, this is super weird, because normally I don't have any trouble.
Oh, you never have trouble. This is your first time encountering an insurmountable difficulty. So difficult, in fact, that it prompted you to call the help desk.
Yeah.
You feel this problem is so tough that it demands assistance from a paid professional. You can't practice nothing. Impossible to figure out.
Did I catch you on a bad day?
Now, why would you say that?
I don't know. It just seems like you kind of have an attitude.
Whoa, I have an attitude? I'm just sitting here minding my own business. I'm not the one who can't log into the network. I'm in the network just fine. I got no problems.
Right, but you work at the help desk.
Oh, you know all about me, don't you? All about me.
Can you just help me, please?
Now you need help? Just a minute ago, you were saying I had an attitude, and now you're begging for my assistance. I don't know, maybe it's cool to insult someone and then demand they help you. That's how it works where you live. You do you, I guess.
So, with my password, please.
All right. Have you tried turning your computer off and on again?
Does that work?
No, I'm just saying stupid stuff to keep you occupied. I'm just making stuff up over here, because that's what I like to do with my free time. Turn your computer off, then turn it back on. Do it. Do it!
Okay, okay. So now I turn it back on?
No, we just leave it off.
Oh.
Of course you turn it back on! You could have turned off your computer and turn it back on again. Did you not understand? Did your brain just cut out after the first part of my instructions?
Sorry, I...
How are you going to log into the network with the computer turned off? How are you going to do that? Are you magic? Do you have magic? Are you a wizard? Are you going to get your wizard wand and abracadabra yourself into the network? Is that what you're planning on doing?
No, I don't know. I don't know.
Is your computer back on yet?
It's booting up.
All right. Guess we'll wait for that then.
I'm doing what you asked me to do.
Not fast enough. I got other people to help, all right? I got people with real problems calling in. And what are they going to do if the line is busy?
I don't know. I just can't log into the network.
And it's my problem that you failed? Take some responsibility for your actions.
I'm trying to. I'm having a hard day.
Oh, I bet you are. It's about to get harder.
No!
Did you enter your password correctly?
Yes!
Did you?
Yes!
Stop lying to me. I know you're lying. Did you enter your password correctly?
I think so.
First those yes, now it's I think so. Which is it?
I don't know. I don't even know who I am anymore. I tried to do the capture thing, and it asked me if I was a robot. and I started thinking about it. And I was like, am I a robot? If I was a robot, would I even know? I mean, maybe I'm a robot that's programmed to think it's a human being. And all of a sudden, I didn't even know if I deserved to get into the network if I couldn't even prove that I was a human. I mean, maybe this is a computer simulation, and I'm just a brain in a vat. And, oh, hold on. I think I got in. Oh, I got in. Thank you. I think I learned something today.
I think you did, lady. I think you did.
You saved me.
Just doing my job. Next time, you're a human being. Remember that.
Thank you.
Because a robot never would have made that dumb mistake.
Along the way, right? How else are you gonna learn and change and grow?
I'm not sure I want to learn and change and grow.
Oh, don't say that, Tanner. Let's unpack that.
I'm trying to order socks, actually, for my feet. I need new socks.
Mm-hmm. That's what's going on the surface. But that's not what's really happening.
That's actually exactly what's happening.
Little word of advice to you. I want you to remove the word exactly from your vocabulary. We are faulty creatures. Our perceptions of the world are not necessarily what is reality. In fact, reality, which I am putting in air quotes, isn't actually a thing. So you need to release yourself from this pathological need to know what is going on?
What is going on?
Wrong question, Tanner. The question is, what do you perceive to be going on?
Is that a question?
Is it? Maybe it is. Maybe it isn't.
So, I perceive that I can't put my credit card information into the open tab.
Cannot or will not?
Nope, cannot. Like, I type numbers into the box and numbers don't appear on the screen.
Right. Think about what you just said. You type in numbers, and numbers don't appear.
Yes.
You type in numbers, and numbers do not appear.
Right.
Why do you think you're the master of numbers? Why do you think numbers have to serve you? Are you a number master?
I'm not sure.
That's the most true statement you've made this entire call. Let me propose. Ask the numbers to appear.
Ask them?
You never asked them, did you? You demanded things from them like they were your servants. But numbers don't serve you, man. You don't own them. You know what numbers are, an agreed upon fiction. Think about that. Three does not exist, man. Three is only what we agreed to be three. And three has refused to go along with that.
I just want socks. I'm just trying to get socks.
No. You say you want socks, but in truth, you're fighting a war with yourself about whether or not reality is what you think it is. You gotta open your mind, man.
So So what should I do?
Ask the numbers to appear with respect. Implore them to join your computer screen.
Okay, 4?
Yep.
6?
Yeah, that's respectful.
5?
How do you feel about 5?
I love
5? 5 loves you. Call 5. Call her.
5! 5? 5!
5 hears you.
I love you, 5!
Call the others. Call back.
7!
9! 1! 1 again! 1 another time! 0! 0! Please hear my call! And 5!
And your expiration date?
Why do you...
Speak your expiration date into the universe!
July 2025!
Yes!
Nothing seems to have happened. Boris? Boris, are you still there? Boris, did you steal my credit card information? Boris!
Thanks for calling the help desk.
I need you to go to it, and
I need you to urinate. Karen? Karen, are you there?
I'm scared.
Be brave, Karen. It's the only way to get it out.
If you say so.
And listen, never buy one of our products again, okay? I don't think you can handle it.
Thank you. You saved my life today.
Just doing my job.
Thank you.
Now go pee and pee like the wind.
Thank you. I'll name my firstborn after you.
Please don't. Also, don't have children. They've got lots of magnesium in them.
Good to know.
I love helping people. Sodium bicarbonate?
Marcus?
What's up, Marcus?
I'm having a bad day, Bailey.
Sorry to hear that.
A real bad day. Do you know why I'm having a bad day?
Climate change?
No.
Natural disasters in your vicinity? Flesh-eating virus? Unsocial rats? Murder hornets?
No, Bailey. I'm having a problem with socks.
Oh.
My socks are malfunctioning, Bailey.
I'm not sure socks can malfunction, sir.
Oh, can't they? I disagree. I have worn these socks for 6 months straight. And do you know what happened?
I can't imagine.
They got a hole in them. Now, how did that happen?
Maybe your feet wore a hole in them.
My feet are pristine. Do you have any clue how beautiful my feet are? My feet wouldn't hurt anyone, and you're insinuating that my lovely feet have attacked some socks? Didn't happen. Did not happen.
I'm not sure this is a huge deal.
How can you say that? I had big plans for these socks. Ruined! I was gonna make cute little puppets with them.
You can still make puppets.
How am I gonna make a little puppet? My puppet has a hole in its head. Was it shot? Was my puppet the victim of a murder? How am I going to explain a murdered puppet to preschoolers?
Hey kids, my name is Jimbo. Pay no attention to the giant hole in my head where I was shot by a rival puppet gang.
The kids are going to be screaming, calling for their mommies.
Oh, don't worry, kids. I was brought back from the dead by a voodoo priest, and now I'm a zombie. Who wants to give me the brains to eat?
But you don't have to say that.
I'm going wherever my heart takes me. Right now, because of my holy socks, it's taking me to some pretty dark places, Bailey. Real dark.
Hey kids, has anyone seen my brains? Oh no, my brains are oozing out! I hope you can sleep well tonight! Here come my brains!
I'm sorry, sir, but our policy is to not refund socks that have been worn every day for 6 months.
Where is your manager?
She's pretty busy.
I want to speak to your manager. Put your manager on.
All right. This is Danny, manager and chief problem solver. I've got your back, noble citizen.
Yeah, I got a problem with Bailey. Big problem with Bailey.
It's just policy, sir.
Hey, you be quiet while I tattle to your boss.
Hit me with it. What happened?
I have some malfunctioning socks. These socks are about to cause children trauma. Do you understand the seriousness of that? And Bailey is super unhelpful. And mean. Big time mean. She won't refund my money. I've never been so outraged in my entire life.
Bailey! Is this true? I explained to him very calmly that we do not refund socks.
Bailey! The customer is always right!
Thank you.
But it's policy.
I don't care about the policy. I care about our customer's feelings. And this customer is very clearly upset. And I know you've been a perfect employee here for the past
You're done!
And what about my 5 rescue golden retrievers?
They're gonna live on the street with you. Serves them right for having such a jerk as an owner. I'm calling security to throw them out of here. Enjoy your new home under the street, you scum!
And I'm so sorry you'll never do it again!
Too late! It's over for you. You're a disgrace!
I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry, golden retrievers. I'm sorry, elderly mother that depends on me.
Hey, you know, I can just use a different song for my
coffee. It's all right, sir.
No, I mean, I don't need anybody to lose their job over this. It's probably my fault for wearing the socks 180 days ago.
Hey there, I got a problem.
Sure you do. That's why you're calling the help desk. Before we start, I have to let you know that this helpline costs 99 cents a minute. Do you accept the charges?
Why do I have to pay to get help?
You want people to help you for free? Out of the goodness of their hearts?
Well...
Do you accept the charges? And I want you to know that whining about the charges costs $5 a minute.
Okay, I accept the charges.
Alright, so it seems to be the problem.
So I bought a Bjornborn engine Falfay.
Oh, the Bjornborn engine Falfay, one of our top sellers.
Right, and I can't seem to put it together.
Even a child can put that together.
Well, actually, I'm on set 47.
That's a good step. One of the best.
Great, but I tried putting little tubing things in the holes, and they kind of get stuck, and I can't get them back out again.
Are you looking at the pictograms?
Yeah, I've got them right here.
The pictograms were designed for people who don't even have the ability to read.
Uh-huh.
So what you're saying is, these designs were built so a toddler could put it together, but it has you stumped.
Well, the tubey things don't fit in the...
So you're confused? You don't know what's going on? I'm surprised you're even capable of finding a phone number on there.
Well, they actually made it hard to find the helpline.
Oh, a lot of things are hard, I guess. Aren't they, little Flynn?
My name is actually Preston.
Poor Preston is having trouble with their dictaphone. Poor Preston!
I'm actually paying for you to help me.
You are incapable of doing this yourself, so you need to pay money to a stranger to help you. That's where you are in your life.
Yes, that's why I called. Help me.
All right. Are there any other competent humans in the house with you? Anyone who can read or handle a tool of any kind?
This seems insulting.
Do you want me to help you or not? Is there anyone else in there with you? A 6-year-old, maybe?
No, just me.
It kind of makes sense.
Why do you say that?
I think it's pretty obvious that if you can't put together a Bjornborn engine Falfay, that no one will ever love you.
What?
Are you going to let me help you, or are you just going to whine?
You're not helping me.
Whining costs $5 a minute, Preston. Do you want that?
Okay, what do? I'm on set 47.
Okay, first I need you to take a deep breath.
Fine.
You didn't take a deep breath.
I did take a deep breath.
I didn't hear a deep breath.
Fine.
That was a sarcastic breath.
You're charging me by the minute.
So maybe you'd better do what I say. Breathe.
I've been breathing.
Not deeply, not sincerely.
This is the most sincere, most deep breath I can do!
Ma'am? Ma'am?
Thank you.
desk. This is Brett.
Hey, I need some help.
Well, you called the right place.
I know I did.
How can I help you?
I need to get rid of my boyfriend.
Not sure I'm the right person to call.
You help people, right? I need help getting rid of my boyfriend. He's terrible.
I'm sorry to hear that. Again, I don't know that
he's worn the same pair of socks for 6 months. 6 months! Can you explain to me the mental state of a person who would do that?
I can't, actually.
He breathes with his mouth open all the time. The boy cannot close his mouth. He's just sitting here wearing the same socks every day, breathing with his mouth open like he's one of those whales that's just sipping ocean water to eat krill. I can't take it anymore!
Have you tried telling him how you feel?
What?
Maybe you should just communicate with him.
Hey, Marcus, close your mouth. Never gonna work. He's dumb, too. The boy is so dumb. He eats out of the garbage. He will literally open the garbage can and rummage through like a raccoon, mouth open the whole time. Flies are going in, but they aren't getting caught. They fly in and they're like, it's really dumb in here, and they escape. Every time I see him, I want to push him into a river.
So, why are you dating him?
He's so cute. Hate him.
Okay. Maybe, instead of complaining to me, you could communicate with him.
Why are you trying to deflect responsibility?
I'm not. I'm just saying.
You're deflecting. You need to help me.
I am helping you.
No, you're just talking. I want action. Surgical action. I want my boyfriend removed. Like I've got a 190-pound cyst on me that needs to be excavated and transported to the nearest landfill.
Not sure how I can do that.
Come up with a plan. Be creative. Think. Do you know people?
I know guys.
People?
Best friend? People. Do you know people?
I know people.
Are these people good at getting rid of unwanted things permanently?
I'm not sure what you're asking.
Oh, I think you know what I'm asking.
Are you really asking me to take care of your boyfriend?
Yes, Brent, I am.
Okay. Hold on. Got an opening. Next Tuesday at 2 a.m. 3-person job. Your boyfriend will never be seen again.
Are you saying you're gonna kill him?
Isn't that what you wanted?
No, my goodness, what is wrong with you?
No, that's what we're asking.
You are sick, more crazy. He's just annoying. He doesn't need to be whacked.
You said take care of.
Yes, as in given job assistance and provided with affordable housing and a nice community.
You said removed.
Yes, as in given a ride to a farm upstate with a gym and a swimming pool and lots of other stupid boys that he can play with in a healthy peer group. What is wrong with you? Do you think you're some kind of mafia help desk?
You're the one who asked if I knew people.
Where is your supervisor? I want to talk to your manager.
Come on.
Put your manager on the phone.
Fine.
This is Danny.
Protection program on my computer.
What?
Nothing. Sorry, I'm just amused. Go ahead.
What are you amused about?
little joke we have here in the office. You don't have to worry about it. I just love my job, that's all. By the way, if you hear me laughing or high-fiving people, just ignore that.
Why would you be high-fiving people?
I just love my team. So you downloaded the virus protection.
Yes, your virus assassin 3?
Oh, you got 3? Hey everyone, I got a customer here who got virus assassin 3. I know, right? Woo!
Yeah, so I downloaded it because it said it would take care of my viruses permanently.
Yep, it says that. Classic.
But as soon as I installed it, I started getting all these pop-ups.
Yep.
And they just say things like, your computer is in danger, or this one, there are viruses coming from your computer and stealing all your information and sending emails to your mom, blaming her for all the problems in your life. I mean, that's really specific. My mom doesn't even know she's responsible for all the problems in my life.
Amazing.
So it seems all Virus Assassin 3 does is just pop-ups on my computer, scaring me.
Sometimes fear is the best motivator.
But that's basically what a virus does.
Yeah?
So how is Virus Assassin 3 different from a virus?
Hey everyone, she's asking how Virus Assassin 3 is different than a virus. Yes, you are right.
What am I right about?
Virus Assassin 3 is a virus. Don't get upset. It's just there to show you how bad a virus can be.
But I paid for it.
I know! You were completely fooled. You made a terrible mistake. This shows how vulnerable you are to other viruses.
It says it murders viruses.
And it does, by becoming one of them. And now, your computer is infected with Virus Assassin 3, which is totally about to beam all your credit card information to the dark web.
The dark web?
Oh yeah, it's scary. That's why it's called the dark web. Pretty soon, organized crime in Morocco is gonna have access to all your contacts and will be calling your grandma.
This is crazy!
I know! You'd be amazed at how many people fall for this.
But how do I get rid of it?
That's where I can help you. We have a specially designed product to take care of Virus Assassin 3. No problems, no questions asked. Virus Assassin Extreme. I know you're worried it's going to be expensive, but it's only a monthly fee of $19.95.
Why is it a monthly fee?
Because it's a subscription service. Virus Assassin 3 is constantly mutating, so you need Virus Assassin Extreme to be constantly adapting to fight it. Don't you know anything about viruses?
How do I know Virus Assassin Extreme isn't just another virus?
I guess you'll just have to trust me.
But you don't seem trustworthy at all.
It's quite a dilemma, isn't it? You really are in a bind. Guys, I think she's gonna buy Virus Assassin Extreme.
I am not doing this.
Aw, you sure?
Yes, you guys are like criminals. I guess I gotta buy a new computer then.
I guess you do. But you're in luck, because we have those too.
Oh.
Thank you. keys. So I gotta hide, and I gotta creep, and I gotta hold on to bees. And they're flying for a while, but then I thought it was gonna rain, and I was worried about my hive. So I took them inside.
You brought the entire hive into your house?
I was worried about them.
But I shouldn't have been, because they're me.
Where is the hive now?
It's inside the kitchen table, but I can't get there, because there are a lot of bees.
Okay, first, you need to calm down. Bees can smell fear.
They can?
Yes, they smell it, and they love it. So stand up, and don't be frightened.
Ow! Ow!
You're doing great.
They keep stinging me.
Oh, are those honeybees?
Yes.
Okay, then, yeah, I was wrong. They can't smell fear. They smell weakness.
I agree.
I know. There's only one thing you can do.
What's that?
You must do battle with the queen.
I have to do battle with the queen?
Absolutely. That's the only way they're going to respect you. You have to assert dominance.
Are you sure you know a lot about bees?
I think it's pretty clear that I know more about bees than you do.
Good point.
We must defeat the queen in one-on-one combat. Then extrude a fragrant odor.
How do I extrude a fragrant odor?
Bees can actually navigate by smell. Amazing.
How do I extrude an odor?
Believe in yourself and a high-fiber diet. Once you've entranced the bees with your scent, you must simply leave them out of the house. Hive, Piper style.
Okay.
On the count of three, charge.
I'm scared.
You should be. One, two, three, charge!
Okay, I got nothing to do.
Oh, right. I'm trying to add more data to my plan.
Oh. Oh, shoot. You're actually going to need someone in account modification then.
Oh.
Simple mistake to make. I don't hold it against you. I'll transfer you over.
Thank you.
Account modification, this is Vic.
Hi, I'm trying to change my plan to add more data.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Slow down. I don't handle data. You're going to need to go to data planning.
The last person told me I was supposed to go to account modification.
Oh man, that was Rich. Was it Brett? It was Brett, right? Don't trust Brett. He just wants you off the bump. He can't actually help you. Data planning's the only one that can help you. I'll send you there.
Okay.
Data planning, this is Miley.
Hi, I'm trying to add more data to my plan.
Oh man, you need customer service.
I've already talked to customer service.
Oh, I can't actually do anything. I can only help you plan your data. I'll send you over to customer service.
Please, just...
Have a nice day.
Customer service, this is Brett.
I'm Brett, I talked to...
Account modification, this is Vic.
Vic, this is Jess!
Doesn't ring a bell.
I just talked to you. You just sent me to data planning, and they said they could only plan data, they couldn't actually change anything.
That's a lie. They're lying to you. Don't take that from them.
They sent me back to customer service.
Customer service is a living nightmare. Don't trust anyone in customer service. Data planning's the only one that can help you.
Can't you help me?
I am helping by telling you to stand up for yourself. If you let them transfer you, they're gonna walk over you your entire life. You need to believe in yourself, Jess.
I just want more data.
Which is why you need to go to data planning. I'll send you there, but remember, you are worth it. Don't believe their lies.
Data planning, this is Miley.
This is Jess. Account modification says you lied to me.
Account modification? You talk to account modification? They're well known for being the biggest liars in this entire company. Don't trust anyone in account modification. I'm your only friend. I'm gonna send you to customer service.
No! Don't send me to customer service!
I can't help you.
You need to help me!
Customer service, this is Brett.
Brett, this is Jess.
Hold on, I'll transfer you.
No! Don't send me away! Don't transfer me!
Look, I don't know what they're telling you, but I can only help customers with squirrel problems.
What?!
That's all customer service does. But, I'll tell you the secret. If you say the words, monster style, to account modification, they're legally required to help you. It's not on the menu, it's not on the website, but it is the secret code.
Monster style?
Yes. Say you want monster style data. I'll send you over.
Account modification, this is Vic.
Monster style!
What?
I want monster style data! I need monster style data! You are legally required to help me!
Did Brett tell you that?
He explained!
You know Brett's a liar, right? He lies.
I just want more data!
But in this case, he was telling the truth. Monster style gets you into special account adjustments.
It does?
Right. I'll send you over.
No! Don't transfer me! You're the only one I trust, Vic!
But special account adjustments are legit. Don't you want more data?
Please!
All right. You need to listen to me very carefully. Special account adjustments will help you, but only if they feel you are worthy.
How do I make them feel I'm worthy?
Respect, politeness, no fear. Can you do that?
I can try.
Don't try, do. I'm gonna send you over there now, all right?
Vic?
Yes?
Pray for me.
I will.
Special account adjustments, this is Mabel.
Hello, and a pleasant day to you. My name is Jess, and I am a valued customer. I'm hoping to add some data to my plan. I know that you are very busy, and I want to let you know that I respect you and your decisions. Please.
You want more data?
Yes, ma'am, I would love more data.
Do you think you deserve more data?
Please, just please, please, for all that is holy, please help me. I can't be on this call anymore. I have a life, I have things to do, I have dreams.
I understand.
And I need data for my dreams.
Absolutely, and they can help you in customer service.
No! No!
All right, all right, I'll help you.
I can't do this anymore, I'm breaking down.
My shift is over, so you're gonna have to call back tomorrow.